వీడియోస్ వైజాగ్ విజన్ ఛానల్ ని సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేసుకోండి. మా ఛానల్ అందిస్తున్న జాతీయ అంతర్జాతీయ స్థాయి వార్తా విశేషాలు నోటిఫికేషన్స్ కోసం ఇక్కడ కనిపిస్తున్న బెల్ ఐకాన్ ని క్లిక్ చేయండి.
ఫైనాన్స్ శ్రీ వివి వేణుగోపాల్ జీ, మీడియా ఆల్సో. ఇట్ ఈస్ మై ప్రివిలేజ్ టు వెల్కమ్.
యాజ్ యు ఆర్ క్వైట్ అవేర్ ఆఫ్ దట్ ద స్టీల్ ఇండస్ట్రీ ఈస్ డూయింగ్ ప్రెటీ వెల్ దిస్ టైమ్ ఆఫ్టర్ దిస్ నేషనల్ స్టీల్ పాలసీ పుట్ ఇన్ టు బీయింగ్ అండ్ కీపింగ్ ఇన్ వ్యూ ద కన్జంప్షన్ ఆఫ్ స్టీల్ పర్టిక్యులర్లీ ఇన్ ఇండియా దట్ ఈస్ అరౌండ్ 72 kg నౌ పర్ కెపిటా అండ్ అరౌండ్ ఇన్ ద rural area it is around 12 kg per capita, which really brings out the futurity of the steel industry in this country. And keeping in view the growth in the manufacturing sector as well as the construction sector and the particularly the strive for the steel industry to go in for 300 million ton capacity generation in the country certainly looks or towards a bright future for this for this company, for this steel industry, for this industry. Now coming to RINL, 2018-19 was a very significant year, and because all the expansions and all the revampings of the existing units, they almost are complete. And we are almost a 7.3 million ton capacity steel plant today. But and if you see the performance, there is 10 to 12% growth in most of the areas like production and improvement in the capacity utilization of the mills and improvement in various techno-economic parameters coming to the projects also, we have made significant improvement in putting up that Coke Oven battery number 5. It's progressively improving. The project will come up in the month of September 2019, and central dispatch yard which is almost ready, and Karethi balancing reservoir that is for water that is also almost ready for performance. And the work at the forged wheel plant, Raebareli, that is our second manufacturing unit, which is coming up in Bareilly, Uttar Pradesh, that is also expected to be commissioned in September 2019. Coming to the marketing front, I am really glad to inform you that there is a growth of around 25% in the sales turnover till date, and there is a 12% growth in the volume of sales. So to nutshell, if you talk about the improvements that we have carried out, we have done in 2018-19, that is hot metal 13%, finished steel 10%, sellable steel 11%, value added steel 34%. I'll tell you, this is quite important because value added steel will give us the sales realization, a higher sales realization, and there is a considerable growth of 34% over last year. RINL also registered improved performance in various techno-economic parameters such as labor productivity, specific energy consumption and specific water consumption. The labor productivity of 542 tons of crude steel per man per year achieved in November 2018 is the best since inception, and the specific water consumption at 2.33 cubic meter per ton of crude steel for the year is comparable to the best in the world. Usage of a pulverized coal in the blast furnace there is an improvement of 10% over last year, but however there is a tremendous scope of improvement in that area which RINL is now looking up to. The sales volume, as I said, has improved over 9% over CPLY, and we are expected to end this year with a sales turnover of around 20,500 crores. Even though there is a considerable increase in the raw material cost and depreciation, because because most of the expansion units are put into operation, so there is a large depreciation which increased by 38%. The company has successfully optimized its operation and could reduce the loss of PBT, that is by 88% against a loss of 1911 crores last CPLY last year. We are expected to end this year with a gross margin of around 1770 crore, and we have up to December we have expressed our result. We have audited our result, and we have made a cash profit of around 660 crores. If you talk about the business diversification, Raebareli forged wheel plant is coming up, and we are expected in September, as I said. And RINL is shortly going to sign a MOU, Memorandum of Understanding, with the KIOCL, Kudremukh Iron and Steel Company, for a pellet plant. And Vizag Steel continue to be used the major products like our steel, so steel that we are supplying, they are all used in very, very prestigious projects like a Polavaram project and Rohtang Tunnel, the Statue of Unity, and Metro Rails, and various important projects of national importance. Our international operation commenced with the opening of the international marketing office at Colombo. We just have started shipping steel to that branch also. And Vizag Steel has added another branch at Indore, that is to the existing 23rd units. It means total 24 units we have now, 24 branches for the marketing. And talks are underway with the Indian Waterways Authority of India Limited to open outlet in the northeast, that is Pandu Port near Guwahati, and utilize multimodal coastal waterways route to cater to the northeast. We supply to steel to northeast. This is what we are looking at. Coming to our CSR achievements, in line with the belief on inclusive growth, RINL has been very proactive in taking a number of CSR projects in the areas of education, healthcare, and social empowerment. An expenditure of around 9 crores. In fact, even because we are a loss-making company till yesterday, so generally we are not obliged, but point is that some important projects that we were doing as a CSR activity, we are continuing with those projects, and we have allotted a budget of around 9 crores for the CSR expenditure this financial year. Coming to recognitions, RINL's overall performance has been well recognized, and a number of awards we have earned, that is National Sustainability Award, that is second prize by Indian Institute of Metals, which were awarded by Indian Institute of Metals.